Uh-oh.
Jamarcus Lawrence, another CBA three-pointer.
Off the offensive rebound. Here. That's what Jamarcus Lawrence can bring to this team tomorrow.
How about two players in common?
Women's basketball takes the airwaves. 12:45 with Jeff Reish and Matt
Cole. Oh, I thought that Penn State had Bella.
For the men's basketball team starts with Kemp Pavelka and Jake Muehlheisen at 4 p.m. as they play Colorado. Tune into your local affiliate or at Huskers.com. Or by using the Huskers mobile app. Go Big Red.
Let Shelker Insurance get you in the game this football season. The Nebraska Huskers are gearing up for another big year. And this
where's Penn State?
Tickets from Shelker Insurance.
No, where? Where is that called?
Contact them. Oh, at Pennsylvania.
In Pennsylvania?
Yeah.
You chance tickets to one of four home football games this season. Only Shelker agents can register you. So
no way. They threw a dime in there. Wow, that's a good one.
Looks like Ohio State's gonna win, Dalton.
Yeah.
Especially if they score.
Blitz before kickoff are presented by the Nebraska Lottery, helping build a better Nebraska.
Richard, Damon, Benny, back with you at Memorial Stadium in Lincoln.
Good coverage, too, really.
This is the 20th meeting all-time between the Huskers and Carolina. Nebraska leads the all-time series 13-5 of the tie, but Illinois has won the last two. Brett Bielema, second year as the head coach of the Illinois Fighting Illini, has them in first place in the Big Ten West. And it's just a month to go before we'll crown a West champion, and one team will be off to Indianapolis to play the East champion in the Big Ten Conference Finals. Illinois has dropped their opening game in conference.
Oh, flag again.
Indiana in that that second week for them. They played a week zero game like Nebraska. It was the opener for Indiana. But after that, they've been able to pick off some teams, including winning at Camp Randall for the first time in 20 years. They put it on the Badgers, so they have the ability to muscle up and pound on people.
Yeah, and stay in the moment too, right? It would be easy to let that one eat at you, but they've been able to build off it and gather some momentum. And here we are, top 20, in some gaudy defensive and offensive statistics. We'll see what holds true to form today.
All right, if you're Bill Bush, a couple of things you want to try to accomplish. What are the last things he's telling his guys in the locker room?
Right now, you want to keep Chase Brown on average. If he gets his 150 yards, you want it to be at about, 30-plus carries where you're thinking dink and dunk. You don't want the yardage to creep up with fewer carries. So being average is good today for Nebraska. The other thing, I want to go back to Jessica's point. Nebraska has to convert on third down and get off the field.
Michigan hammered him.
Michigan hammered
42-17. So they have a pre-course survey we gotta take first.
I
have no idea.
I wouldn't start it until you can.
No, I'm not going to.
I assume you
can. What makes me queasy just watching. I'm not a guy that's built for that.
I hate having to do it during the game.
I'm not
going to. Three more, so a total of six about ready to come down. He did a nice job. He's been beautiful landings. They have to like the fact that it's not very windy here today. Just a very slight breeze out of the southwest. But a couple of miles per hour. Here's our fourth one. Boy, he's got a looping over the folks in the east stands. And landing down near the 20-yard line of the
I thought the guy told us between 3 and 4 hours.
What guy's that?
So, two more to come arriving, and then we'll get into the tunnel lock. Huskers back in the locker room. Hearing from Mickey.
You get some stuff?
There he is. Huge Husker flag on the back of this fella. Oh, this is a tandem.
Look at this here. Tandem.
Now they split apart. And the Husker flag guy lands at about the third 20-yard line on the south end.
Oh, cool.
And they're all down safely. That was really cool to watch that.
It's darn it. It might be on, Dalton.
Maybe you should turn it over.
Okay. There's one more. This one might have the game ball. Usually the last one comes in as the game ball.
One minute to go.
Well,
41-24, a minute and a half to go.
It's not going to be on until this game is over. You can turn it back if you want to, Dalton.
No.
Okay. It's probably going to be at least 5 minutes or more.
It's incredible theater. It's why people keep coming back.
Being South Syracuse has no time left. No, it'll be pretty fast.
It will be fast.
Even if Nebraska wants to have some sort of a semblance of what they used to be, you have to start to take advantage and make the friendly confines.
They score 37-24.
And the big American flag is the last to come down in. And then the last parachuter makes it down.
And we didn't have parachuters when we went.
Walks away from that as well. Beautiful. Outstanding. Fun to watch all that happen here at Memorial Stadium.
Complete the post-course survey here.
Football's great traditions. Nebraska's Tunnel Walk. They've got a shot of Mickey Joseph up. Let's listen in.
Probably there's just some highlights from Rutgers and Purdue and Indiana on the TV. Right, Dan?
Yeah. Well, this game was kind of a surprise the way that both teams have been playing. I sure didn't see Notre Dame beating them. Kickoff 336.
What are they showing? Is that Lincoln?
Syracuse, New York.
Oh, why?
Your preparation. You're ready to see if opportunity meets preparation in this one. This will be electric.
Mickey Joseph wearing the black sweat tops. The gates are still closed. The northwest corner.
We're not going to get to see R.C. Dalton because this game is locked. Dalton was asking me if we get to see where he's at.
He says the gates are still closed.
I know.
Got half a minute to go here.
Yeah, we're not. They're going to open the country.
One more play here.
Huskers walk out. Mickey Joseph clapping his hands, waving his arms, getting the crowd fired up. Here come the Huskers.
They're going to build the other team, giving away.
If they come out at the same time, they will.
And Brett Billman now leads out the final line from the Southwest Tunnel. Big 10 football, about ready to get unloaded.
They're booing the other team, giving away.
For the tunnel, they tell it almost extends clear to the other sideline for the guys to run out through.
Yeah, if you're looking for a game day experience from this staff and the admin team and an environment that it breeds recruiting, this one's it today at 2:30 here in Lincoln, Nebraska.
I'll talk to Mickey about his gait a little bit. He's got to get going a little bit.
There we go. There we are.
He got bypassed pretty quick.
Up. There you go. Rumbling kick coming away on ABC. Also, we're 2 minutes away from the American Showdown
in the Bounce House. Number 20, Cincinnati in Orlando, taking on. Kick off in 3 minutes. 6:30. 2:36. Husker flags, Husker flag flying, Cowboy flag flying, all is good. We're going to give it a whirl. I don't know. Hey, we got to pull the ribs off here in like 15 minutes.
Okay.
Don't forget that.
Oh, where the air they came in.
First place in the West Division is on the line today at Memorial Stadium as 17th ranked Illinois, off to its best start in over a decade, visits the Nebraska Cornhuskers on the final college football Saturday of October. The Illini at 3-1 in Big Ten play, best record through four league games since 2000. Nebraska, after a coaching change, playing much better, can tie for the division lead with a win today. And hi, everybody. Dave Pasch alongside Dusty Dvorak. We'll check in with Tom Luganville in a little bit. Well, Illinois, Dusty, is one of the best stories this year in college football. Brett Bielema has turned the program around. They have the leading rusher in the country, and they also have one of the best defenses in all of college football.
Yeah, Chase Brown's been tremendous on the ground, but defensively, this squad is absolutely outstanding. One of the best secondaries in all of college football. They take the ball away, and unbelievable mark, 12 interceptions.
First.
Absolutely rush the passer. Young 36-year-old defensive coordinator Ryan Walters has one of the best units in all of college football.
So a challenge for Casey Thompson, the Nebraska quarterback, to try to solve this Illini defense, but he has to cut down on his turnovers to help get under that coach Mickey Thompson, who replaced the fire Scott Frost a month and a half ago.
See, Bill.
Everyone's playing this song now. I don't know what it's from.
Wisconsin coach that at Arkansas took over a year ago. He's won 9 of his last 12.
Sounds like he's...
Spanish bullfighting. Yeah. Okay. We always win the toss.
Illinois gets the ball first.
You're right.
I don't know why we want to do that. But okay. So we can have it first coming out of half. We usually don't do a dang thing. There you go. We're so concentrated on stopping the run, they'll probably throw us to death. Terrible on third down.
Come on, but not this game. Not this game. Oh, here we come. Here we come! Oh, shooter, wooter.
We're terrible on third down. We sold out to try to sack him and didn't get the...
I guess.
No one was him. Well, when you're not guarded.
Safety was...
Oh!
Hmm.
All right.
It looked like it was good from...
It did, didn't it?
It was going that way, but it looked like it was good.
Alrighty. Mom.
Don't tear those off.
What?
Well, I want them big enough.
I know.
Okay. It's kind of like you're wrapping a Christmas present. The paper's not over bringing it. It's okay. We got 15 minutes.
Actually not.
Well, it wasn't even up to temperature when you put them on.
You're back to work over here.
Hmm?
Neighbors, they're back to work over there.
Oh.
They got a crew.